Anti-terrorist police in London are tonight holding a man believed to be wanted by the RUC in connection with sectarian murders in Belfast. He was arrested in London yesterday evening, and police there say he'll probably be transferred to Belfast over the weekend. The Construction Industry Federation, representing employers in the building sector, has asked the High Court to intervene in a dispute about wet time payments to 40,000 building workers. The unions say employers have failed to honour a legally binding agreement on minimum payments. The Taoiseach Minister for Energy, Mr. Spring, says the search for offshore oil will continue. That's despite 1984's poor results. He says they haven't dampened the oil industry's interest in this country's prospects. An ESB union says there could be a strike if there isn't any progress in pay talks later this month. The ESB Officers Association maintains that the report on electricity prices that's just been issued was timed to influence the current pay round. The United States has suspended peace talks with Nicaragua. They've been going on in Mexico since the middle of last year. Yesterday, the United States said it was refusing to take part in further hearings at the International Court in The Hague on Nicaragua's complaint about the mining of its ports. At home here, weather conditions are still bad. The AA has advised motorists to postpone journeys if they can. It says the worst affected areas are Wexford, Waterford, Wicklow, Monaghan, Cavan, Sligo, Longford and Roscommon. Many sporting fixtures have been cancelled, including the rugby international between Ireland and England at Lansdowne Road. And the prospects for the next few hours, well, there'll be sharp to severe ground frost and fog in many areas. Rain, sleet or snow in parts of Leinster, Ulster and Munster is largely dying out. That's it. Stay warm. Good night.